Go.
Hi, I'm Tammy Dillingham Lewis. I am Brandon's mother. And this is...
I'm Boston Daniel Lewis. I'm Brandon Lewis' father.
So we are the proud parents. Two boys and one girl. With Brandon being the baby and I...
Well, all I want one of the things I want to know is how did you guys feel when y'all know when y'all knew y'all was pregnant with me? Like, how did you feel about it? Were you excited? Were you nervous?
We were very excited, but we're gonna start like this. I met your father one day. I was working in the doctor's office. I went with some friends. And that was your dad's part-time job, and that's where we met. Your father and I went together about a month. He asked me to marry him, and I was excited, and I said yes. And about a year later, not even a year later, months later, that was in June, the last of June, he asked me to marry him. And we got married February the 12th of the following year, which was 1994. Going on into our marriage, yes, we had planned to have kids. You were surprised. I was having issues with my heart, and I thought something was wrong with my heart. With my family having heart disease, I decided one day I was at work, hey, I'm gonna go on and get off and go to the doctor.
Mm-hmm.
Went to the doctor because I thought, like I said, there was something wrong with my heart. Turns out I was expecting a baby. I was very excited. It was a year into our marriage and I was expecting a baby. Well, was it a year into our marriage?
Yeah.
He was supposed to be born in January of 96. He surprised us in October 95.
Yeah.
So when your dad got home, well, when I got home, your dad was at home. And me being giddy, I went on and told our parents. They were excited. I came home and I told your daddy. His excitement wasn't what I expected. But in the midst of us finding out, or in the midst of me having a problem pregnancy, your dad's attitude and his love and his care, really, he really showed a lot of love and care, a lot of concern. He was really there for me. And when it came to the doctor visit, of course, because of the way we were working, a lot of times he wasn't able to make it to the doctor with me. And at the time, we were still newly married, so he wasn't able to go to the doctor with me, but he'd always want to know how everything went, if I'm having issues, I'm having problems. Your daddy was on it. When I started having issues and problems with my sleep pattern or the way I slept, your daddy, he was like an old-fashioned person. He fixed the bed or positioned the bed so it would be more comfortable for me. Uh-huh. Raised the head of the bed up so I wouldn't be laying flat. He was an outstanding husband, and when the day that I started having issues, of course he had went to work. I called my job and I let him know, hey, I'm having some issues. I called the doctor's office and they told me, oh, it's probably just, you're only 6 months. It's probably the baby pushing against your bladder. But it happened to be, I went on to work, and they sent me, I went to the doctor, and it happened to be that I was about to go into labor in 24 weeks. And the doctor that I had down here, which I was going to, his information was way off. When I did go to the doctor for my last appointment, I was having issues. I was telling the doctor about how it felt like at the time that my baby was about to push out of me. And he's like, oh, grandma, you about 28 weeks, everything will be all right. No, everything's not going to be all right. But that was on a Saturday. And that Wednesday was when I really started having issues. So when I came back to the doctor that Wednesday after getting off work, they said, well, if your tissue's disrupted, then it's not going to be good. They did a pap smear, or they did something to examine me, but they did it with a little pap smear viewed, and that's when it was like my water just, and when the doctor got up, when the doctor stood up, he told me that this baby finna die, we finna send this baby to baby heaven, as if he was saying, hey, we just won the lottery. And I don't feel like you would tell anybody that's going through labor and expecting a baby or any thing in life, you would not explain it to them that way. And I thought, you know, this can't be, you know, my baby's not gonna die. My baby's not gonna die, he's gonna survive. So they call your dad over, and he was at work, they called him, and he was like, they gave him the wrong name. He's like, it can't be, my wife ain't named Debbie, and she's not far enough along. You know, she's not far enough along to be in labor. But when he came and saw the car was there, he came on in along with your auntie and your brother. And your dad asked the doctor, can we save the baby? And he said, well, I already say the baby will be millions and millions of dollars. Well, not millions of dollars, but close to a million. He said, I didn't ask you how much it costs. I asked you, can we save? We got sent on over to the hospital, and we're going to see what we can do. Well, of course, that's when the ball started to roll. But I knew you were going to be okay. Because when the doctor told me this baby finna die, we finna send this baby to baby heaven. Of course, I started crying. The nurse that was in there with me, I can't say her name, but she was she was trying to comfort me. She said, you want me to call your husband? She was the one that left out the room to call my husband. I was in there by myself. Nobody is in there. And I felt this touch on my shoulder as the like somebody was comforting me, saying that it's going to be okay. I felt like a hand on my shoulder. It was a touch. And from that touch on my shoulder, this feeling of comfort, love, joy, and I feel like you're going to be all right. It just filled all over my body like something was spilling over me. And you started wiggling like a little fish. And I grabbed my stomach and I say, my baby's going to live. My baby's going to be all right. And from there we went to the hospital. We stayed at Hospital at night. We had another nurse there. She was so sweet, trying to make sure that I go to Birmingham. She tried to send me out there the full night, but I ended up going like 5 o'clock that